Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all to today's NVIS webinar topic, Know Your Freshwater Fishes by Cincy Varghese. Cincy is pursuing her PhD in Ecoinformatics and has been part of EWRG since 2012 and has been mostly working on wetlands of Bangalore and Uttarakhanda. She has extensively monitored several lakes of Bangalore and also monitored lotic ecosystem and soil of Central Western Ghats, and has trained several students of different schools and colleges in field monitoring, water quality assessment of lakes, rivers, methods of sample collection of water, soil and planktons, and as well as identification of microscopic organisms like algae and zooplankton. Her major area of interest are monitoring of aquatic ecosystem, water quality assessment, soil quality assessment, algal culturing in wastewater, fish, algae and zooplankton. And she has also published in several peer-reviewed journals, majorly focusing on wetlands and stream, as well as technical reports related to mostly wetlands in Bangalore. So I welcome Cincy Varghese for today's webinar topic. Over to you, Cincy.
Thank you, Deepthi, for the introduction. Good evening to all. Now I will discuss on Know Your Freshwater Fishes. മത്സ്യരൂപായ വിഷ്ണുദേവായ പ്രളയപയോധിച്ച ദേവദേവായ ഓം നമോ ഭഗവതി മത്സ്യദേവായ ഫിഷ് ഈസ് കൺസിഡർഡ് ആസ് വൺ ഓഫ് ഗോഡ് വിഷ്ണുസ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇൻകാർണേഷൻ ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യൻ മിത്തോളജി ആസ് ഇൻ മത്സ്യ അവതാര ഇൻ ദിസ് ഇൻകാർണേഷൻ Lord Vishnu is believed to have saved the first human, Manu, on earth by informing him of the flood that were to follow. The knowledge of the occurrence of fish in India dates back to 3 million BC. Aquaculture in India has long history with the reference of fish culture in Kautilya's Arthashastra and King Someshwara's Manasoltara. The local worship of the fish god is a key driver of conservation at various lakes in India, where the fishes are fed regularly by local people and tourists. Since species of mahaseer, the golden mahaseer, Tor putitora, are mentioned in various religious scriptures, they are protected in several structures of rivers associated with a temple where fishing is prohibited, and local communities, pilgrims and temple authorities help to monitor and safeguard the fish population. Thus, fishes are considered sacred. So, it is very important to conserve our inland water body and fishes. Inland water system includes habitats such as lakes and rivers, marshes, swamps and floodplains, small streams, ponds, etc. We have two types of ecosystem. One is lindic ecosystem, another one is lotic ecosystem. Lindic ecosystem means the stagnant water. For example, lakes and pond. The lotic ecosystem means running water, the streams and rivers. In our aquatic food chain, we have three different types of fishes. First one is piscivorous fish, then planktivorous fish and benthivorous fish. The benthivorous fish will eat detritus. They disturb sediments. Then nutrients will enter to the water. These nutrients our phytoplanktons like microalgae will use, and they produce food. They are our primary producer. So then zooplankton will eat microalgae. Then the planktivorous fish, that means the planktivorous fish means they will eat planktons like zooplankton and phytoplankton. The planktivorous will eat zooplankton and the phytoplankton. Then piscivorous will eat fish species like the small planktivorous fish. This cycle repeats. Then coming to the introduction. What is fish? Fishes are cold-blooded animals with a backbone. They are vertebrates. Gills for breathing underwater and paired fins for swimming. They live underwater and depends on water for dissolved oxygen, support, food and shelter. Fish diet consists of aquatic insects, phytoplankton, zooplankton, plants and other fish. The fishes are an important ecological link in the food chain. They serve as food for other fish, herons, pelicans, eagle, alligator, turtles, other wildlife, and humans. General concepts on fish. Ichthyology. In Greek, ichthys or ichthys means fish. Logos means study. Ichthyology is the branch of zoology devoted to the study of fishes. This includes bony fishes, cartilaginous fish, and jawless fish. The classes like Acinonta, they means lacking, and Ganthos means jaw. The chondrichs, this chondrus means cartilage, and ichthys means fish. So the cartilaginous fishes. Then osteichthys. Osteum means bone. Then we can call it as a bony fishes. The evolutionary history. The first fish-like creatures appeared over 500 million years ago. The bony fish and the cartilaginous fish diverged into separate classes about 420 million years ago. In our world, fish classification, the under the kingdom under the Animalia, then phylum under Chordata, subphylum under the Vertebrata. The three different classes, jawless fish, cartilaginous fish, and the bony fishes. In case of bony fish, the Actinopterygii is the most dominant with the 46 orders, 487 families and 4,895 genera. About 21,730 species of fishes have been recorded in the world, of which about 11.72% are found in Indian waters. In the current study, the we in India has the total 2,719 fish species. In that, marine fishes are 1,808. Freshwater fishes are 994. This table shows the different orders with the different families and common name. In that, in our India, the most dominant order is Cypriniformes. In that, Cyprinidae, we can call it as minnows or carps. Second one, the Perciformes, like Channidae, snake-haired fish, and Cichlidae, cichlid. And Siluriformes, we can call it as a catfish. There are about 450 families of freshwater fishes globally. Roughly 40 are represented in India, that freshwater fishes. Then about 25 of these families contain commercially important species. Some examples are Bagarius bagarius, Katla katla, Channa maruleus, then Sirhinus mrigala, Clarius batrachus, then Notopterus notopterus, Rita rita, Vallago attu, etc. In that, Katla katla, Sirhinus mrigala, Clarius batrachus, Labio ruhida are present in our Bangalore lakes. Fish collection and identification. For fish collection, we need boat, dragnet, cast net, hook and lines, then gill net, cage trap, and dip net. An unidentified specimens are preserved in 10% formalin solution. The fishes can be identified up to the species level by its natural color, pattern of scales, fins, mouth pattern, paired and unpaired fins, and body part using standard literatures. One of the examples, the order Cypriniforms. Some example, the common carp, mrigal, and cutler. The largest order of freshwater fishes in with 2,600 to 2,700 species in the world. Body with a small to large scale. Head without a scale. Then mouth toothless. Then single dorsal fin. Then barbels present around the mouth or absent. You can see here the barbel. Then example, Cyprinidae family, carps and minnows. Another one is the Siluriforms. That we can call it as a catfish. Some example, Magur, then Vallago atu and Ompok species. The commonly called as catfishes. They present a long barbels around the mouth in most species. Then eyes are small. Then body is devoid of scales. Then the spines present at the front of the dorsal and then pectoral fin also. Then air breathing organs present in Clydidae and Heteropneustidae. The total species in the world, that is 2,400. In that, 2,300 species are present in freshwater fishes. Then, in our India, we have 150 species of catfishes. Another order is Perciforms. Some example, Chanapundatus, Anabas, Oreochromis, and Ictroplus. It includes perches and perch-like fishes. Fins usually with the spines on the pelvic, dorsal, and anal fin. Tail fin may be forked or rounded. Then scales are large and prominent. One example, we can take the Oreochromis niloticus, the scientific classification, the kingdom Animalia, then phylum Chordata, then class Actinopterygii, then order Perciforms, family Cichlidae, then genus Oreochromis, and species Oreochromis niloticus. Then other part of the fish. For example, Oreochromis niloticus, they have mouth, eye, then dorsal fin with the spines, then caudal fin, then anal fin with the spines, then pelvic fin and pectoral fin. They have vent, that is the reproductive organ. Then we can identify female and male. Then, in fish has eyes. The sight organ of a fish. The fish can detect color. Then brain, the control center of the fish. All sensory information is processed here. Next one is mouth. The mouth shape is a good clue to what fish eat. We have three different types of the fish has three different types of mouth, that is superior mouth, then inferior mouth and terminal mouth. In superior mouth, a mouth that open upward, that is usually surface feeders. Inferior mouth, a mouth that opens downward, usually bottom feeders. Terminal mouth, a mouth located at anterior end of the fish body, that is midwater feeders. For detail, we can see here surface feeder. Surface feeder have an obtained mouth for skimming the water surface for food. Then another one is the column feeder. They have a mouth that appears straight from the face to gather food as it falls through the water. Another one, the bottom feeders. How? They have the downtained mouth for feeding from the bottom of the water body. We have two types of carps. One is Indian major carps and another one is the exotic carps. In Indian major carps, Katla, Rohu and Mrigal. The Katla is a zooplankton feeder, so we can call it as a surface feeder. Then Rohu, that is the omnivorous, that is column feeder. Then Mrigal, that is detritivorous, that is bottom feeder. Then in exotic carps, first one is grass carp, that is herbivorous, that is surface feeder. Then silver carp, phytoplankton feeder, that is also the surface feeder. Then the common carp, that is detritivorous, that is we can call it as a the bottom feeder. Next one, gills. Gills are the feathery tissue structure that allows fish to breathe in water. The gills are like lungs. The water flows in through their mouth and over their gills, where oxygen is extracted and passed into the bloodstream. Next one is dorsal fins. This is the dorsal fin. The dorsal fins are the stabilizing fins. They are used to keep the fish upright and for fast swimming and jumping. Helps maintain balance while swimming. Next one is the pectoral fin. This is the pectoral fin. The two pectoral fins are usually behind the gill. Here it's a gill opening. They are used for steering, allow side to side movement, and also allows the fish to stay in one spot. It also acts as a brake to decrease speed while swimming. Another one is pelvic fin. In pelvic fin, stabilizes the fish while swimming, allows for up and down movement in the water, aids in slow swimming, and pelvic fins are sometimes called as a ventral fins. Next one is anal fin. This is the anal fin. Anal fin stabilizes the fish while swimming. The anal fin is used for balance the rapid movement of the fish in water. The last fin is the caudal fin, that is we can call it as a tail fin. The caudal fin is at the end of the fish body. The caudal fin is used to help the fish move forward at a great speed. The type of caudal fin, the round, forked, then square and lunate. The round tail, it's for slow swimming. One of the example is Heteropneustes fossilis. Then truncated tail for turning quickly. One of the example is Cenintodon cancella. Another one is forked tail. That is rapid swimming. That is example is Labiorohita. The lunate, that is moon-shaped tail. This is mainly the marine species has this type of tail. That is continuous long distance swimming. One example is dolphin. Another one is lateral line. This is the lateral line. The lateral line is found on both side of the fish body from the operculum to the caudal fin. The lateral line senses water, current and pressure and sensitive to vibration, then movement and sound in the water. It allows fish to locate predators and find prey. Another one is scale. The scale is most bony fishes are either stenoid or cycloid. The stenoid scales have jagged edges. This one. This is example is tilapia. And cycloid scale have smooth rounded edges. Example is has the Channa pundatus. The scale protects the fish from injury. The catfish has no scales. The other fish like rohu, katla, tilapia has scales. Next one, the barbels. Barbels are sensory organs to track prey or food. Another one is vent. It is the external opening to digestive, urinary and reproductive tracts immediately in front of the anal fin. The vent removes waste and extra water. It is also the outlet for eggs or milt during spawning. This is the fish egg. Muscle. This is the muscle of catfish. They provide movement and locomotion. It is the part of the fish that is usually eaten. The paired nostrils. This here it will see the nostril. Used to detect odors in water and it can be quite sensitive. Catfish and eels have well developed senses of smell. This is the kidney. Kidney filters waste material from the blood, regulates water and salt concentration in the body. The spinal cord here connects brain to, here is the brain. The connects brain to rest of body, relays information from the brain to the rest of the body. Spine, primary backbone of the fish, made up of vertebrae that protect the spinal cord. Next one, heart. The fish has two chambered heart. One chamber receives deoxygenated blood from body. The other pumps blood to the gills where it picks up oxygen and releases carbon dioxide. Circulate blood throughout the body, also circulate oxygen and digested nutrients. This is the liver. Liver is very important organ. Why? Because this secretes enzyme to aid in digestion, store fats and carbohydrates. Next one, swim bladder. The swim bladder is a long, skinny organ that can inflate or deflate with the air, allowing fish to float at a different level in the water column. The swim bladder makes a fish buoyant so that it does not sink when it stops swimming. Another important thing means they conserve energy instead of constant swimming. This is the stomach. Here is the intestine. Stomach and intestine break down or digest food and absorb nutrients. The piscivorous fish, that means eat other fish, have fairly short intestine because such food is easy to chemically break down and digest. Herbivorous fishes that eat plants that requires longer intestine because plant matter is usually through usually tough and fibrous and more difficult to break down. Food and feeding habitats of fish. The feeding habitat of fishes differ from species to species. Fishes can be classified according to what they often eat. In that, the herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, and detritivores. The herbivores, they eat mostly plant sources material. Carnivores, they eat animal than plants. Omnivores, they will eat both plants and animals. The detritivores that eat detritus. In this figure, we'll tell about the herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. We have different types of fish species and different types of feeding habitat. First one, we can take it as a phytoplankton feeders. That is our example of the herbivores. The one example is silver carp. This will consume microalgae and filamentous algae. The plankton feeder example is grass carp. They will consume the macrophyte and filamentous algae. The zooplankton feeders, that example is bighead carp. They will consume copepods, cladocereus and rotifers and the plankton, phytoplanktons also. Then common carp, that is we can call it as a bottom feeders. They will consume the worms, insects, insect larvae, snails, then the zooplanktons and the macrophytes. Then the carnivores, for a carnivore species, that example is catfish. We can call it as a predators. They will eat only fish, frogs, insects. Sexual reproduction. Most have external fertilization. The female lays a large number of eggs and then male deposit sperm on top of them. The spawning places of freshwater fishes. We have still or stagnant water and running water. Here in stagnant water, the fish species lay a large number of eggs on stones or water column or holes on water plants or bottom. Then some will make a nest with the bubbles that form nest, and some they will keep their eggs in their mouth. In running water, the female fish lays a large number of eggs on stones, then water column, then bottom, then holes and roots. Some freshwater fish in spawny season, that means in the rainy season, they will migrate to floodplains, paddy field or wetlands. Mainly in our native species will migrate to this place. So we wanted to conserve our floodplain. Why? Because we wanted to conserve our fish. The parental care in fishes. In time, parental care can be defined as an association or bond between the parents and their offspring to increase the chances of the survival of their eggs. It includes the events after the spawning or after hatching of the egg and caring of the offspring by the parents. For example, tilapia mozambica. The fish young ones take shelter into the mouth of the female fish whenever they sense any sort of danger. Distribution of parental care in fishes. The 77% shows no parental care. The 17% shows the care of egg only. Then 6% care for egg and newly hatched young ones. The advantages of parental care in fishes, the survival, protection, then contribute to reproductive fitness, then increased growth rate and quality, then better development. Next, importance of fishes. Fishes are good indicators of the water quality. And the importance of fishes, the fishes are good indicators of the water quality and health of the ecosystems. Fish is an ideal human food. It is nutritious, high in protein, minerals, vitamins, beneficial omega oil, low in fat and cholesterol. The demand for freshwater fish is increasing as more people are realizing the health and fitness values of eating fish. This table shows the composition of some Indian food fish. Magur, that is Caryes batrachus, mola, that is Amblypharyngeus garden mola, then chana, that is Chana pundatus, rohu, that is Labio rohita, then katla, mrigal, Sirhinus mrigala, then common carp, Cyprinus carpio. We can see here, compared to fat, the protein content is higher. So, in this table shows the common carp has the 20.84, in other fishes has the 19. This is exotic species. These all are our native species, Indian major carps, and these all are our native species. They have also high amount of protein. So we wanted to conserve our native fish species. Then another thing, this column will show the commonly found fishes in freshwater. The fish species with the common name with the Kannada name. The Katla, we can call it as a Katla in Kannada, Katla or Dodda Gende. Then Sirhinus mrigala, then mrigal in Kannada also same. Then Caryes batrachus, that is Magur, Anemino. Then Caryes gadipinus, African catfish, that is also called as a Anemino. Then Stenopharyngeus idellus, that is grass carp. This is the grass in Kannada is hullu, that means hullu gende. Then Cyprinus carpio communis, that is we can call it as a common carp. Common means samanya gende. Then Gambusia affinis, that is mosquito fish, that is in Kannada Gambusia or Solemino. Then Labio fimbriata, that we can call it as a fimbriatus. Then Kemino. Then Labio rohita, that is rohu. Then Oreochromis mozambicus and Niloticus, we can call it as a tilapia in common name. In Kannada, we can call jilebi. Then Parambasis renka, that is in common name Indian glassy fish, that is in Kannada Bechanike mino. In this, the Gambusia affinis is a mosquito control fish. Then most exotic fish species found in India. The Stenopharyngeus idella, that is grass carp from Japan in 1959. Then Cyprinus carpio communis, that is common carp from Bangkok in 1957. Then Gambusia affinis, that is mosquito fish, for mosquito control from Italy in 1928. Oreochromismus sanguicus, that is tilapia, from Bangkok in 1952. Then Hypophthalmitis mellitus, that is the silver carp, from Hong Kong in 1959. The Ramchandra et al. 2011, they studied about the ecological and social economic assessment of Varthu wetland, Bangalore. In that study, they listed the major fish species in Varthu wetland during 1962, 1998 and 2009. In 1962, in Varthu Lake has Clarius batrachus, Heteropneustes fossilis, then Meisters dittatus. In 1998, in Katla, then Rohu, Mrigal, African catfish, then tilapia and minor carps also present. But in 2009, the only the Clarius gadipinus, this was present. But in 9th September 2016, this species also died. Why? Because this water is more polluted because of the sea, the untreated sewage water entering to the lake. Here we can see that the Clarius gadipinus has the air breath organ. This species can survive. Then, if the catfish cannot survive in Varthu lake water, no other species can. The biotic and abiotic factors. In biotic factors and abiotic factors, it's very important. Why? Because this will affect the fish growth, fish reproduction, then fish survival. Then first one, the biotic factors like prey, algae, then microorganism, predator, other species. The algae, the algal blooms occurs when the sewage water entering to the water, entering to the lake, then algal blooms will occur. Then their dissolved oxygen will decrease. In that time, the fish species will die. Then another important the factor is predators. The we will introduce in the exotic species like catfish, tilapia and all. Then the survival of our native species is decreasing. Then abiotic factors like oxygen, pH, light, temperature, total suspended solids, minerals, salinity, space, toxic materials, ammonia and nitrite. The for fish growth, it is the optimum, the DO is, that is 5 milligram per liter. In then pH, that is 6.5 to 9. Then the because of the suspended particles, fish will get injured and infections also. Then the toxic materials and ammonia, because of this contamination, then fish kill will happen. The fish mortality in lakes of Bangalore, this is in 2016 at Alsur Lake, Bangalore. The causes of fish mortality in lakes of Bangalore, that is in Sankey Lake, Lalbag Lake, the depletion of DO because of the sewage let into the lake in 1995. In Alsur Lake, because of chemical flushed into lake. Then Jekor Lake, the oxygen depletion because of the sewage let into the lake in 2015. Then Sankey Lake, that mainly toxic algal blooms in August 2013. Then Devarabhisanahalli Lake, because of the organic pollution in the November 2010. Their other lakes like Dorekere, Chekur, then Putenahalli, Alsur, Devarabisinahalli, etc., that because of the sewage flood, in different years, that the fish mortality, it happened. The threats of fishes. Many factors contribute the loss of fish species and the degradation of their habitat. This include habitat alteration, then construction of dams, then reductions of natural habitat area, then water pollution, especially spill of toxic waste, that is industrial acid, pesticides and fertilizers, then sedimentations from agriculture, construction, logging and mining area, then diversion of riverbeds for urbanization, then introduction of exotic species, then the use of explosive poisons and electro fishing by poachers, then overfishing, then global climatic variations. The conservation measures to maintain fish biodiversity includes: do not harvest the fish during spawning period, do not harvest juveniles, do not allow the introduction of invasive species such as African catfish, tilapia, etc., into lakes. Then educate locals about the life cycle of freshwater fish and the negative impact of pollution with the sewage, fertilizers, pesticides, and other anthropogenic activities. According to the Handbook of Fisheries Statistics, in 2018, the India is currently world's second largest producers of fish. It is also world number two in aquaculture production as well as in inland capture fisheries. The total fish production in 2017 to 2018 was 12.59 million metric tons. In that, the 8.9 million metric tons from inland sector and 3.69 million metric tons from marine sector. The average growth in fish production during 2017 to 2018 stands at 10.14%. The sector accounts for 5.23% share of agricultural GDP. The fisheries is a fast growing sector in India, which provides nutrition and food security to the large population and provides income and employment to more than 14.5 million people. This graph shows the fish production during recent years from 2005 to 2018. We can see here the marine, then inland and total. Here in 2017 to 2018, we can see here the most part from inland water, that is 71%, from only marine only 29%. This one shows the major fish production producing state in 2017 to 2018. Here the y-axis explains the lakhs the fish the lakhs in tons, lakh tons, and the x-axis represent the state. We can see here the Andhra Pradesh given 34.5 in lakhs tons, and second the West Bengal, that is 17.42. Then in our Karnataka, that is 6.03 lakh tons. The state-wise inland fish production during 2011 to 2018, here the Andhra Pradesh given the major part, that is 28.45 lakh tons, and then West Bengal 15.57, then Uttar Pradesh 6.29. The state-wise marine fish production, here the Gujarat is the most dominant. They are given the major part, that is 7.01 in lakh tons. Then Andhra Pradesh, that is 6.05. In Karnataka and Kerala, they are given the 4.14 lakh tons. The aquaculture is a rapid growing fisheries settled in India with an annual growth rate of over 7%. Freshwater aquaculture contributes over 95% of the total annual aquaculture production of 5.77 million tons. The Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal are the top producers of freshwater fish through aquaculture. In the fish requirement by 2020 is expected to touch 15 million tons, of which around 9 million tons would need to come from the freshwater aquaculture. This graph shows the export value of fish and fishery products in India from financial year 2011 to financial year 2018. This graph shows the increasing trends from 2011 to 2018. Here, in 2018, the export value of fish and fisheries products in India, that is equal to 476.4 billion Indian rupees. These are the some fish products: fish vada, fish cutlet, fish chakli, then fish sail, then fish papad, then fish balls, different types of fish pickles, etc. So the fish protein is good for health. Save lakes for fish, do not pollute water bodies, then save fish and eat healthy fish. Eat fish every day, keep you away from arthritis, respiratory disease, etc. Now, I wish to thank Dr. T.V. Ramchandra, the coordinator, EWRG CSIEC Bangalore, for giving me this opportunity and support in my research work. Then thank you Asilaba for overall supports. Then thank you the NVIS webinar coordinators Bharat Setur and Deepthi Hebbale for technical support. Thank you all.
Thank you, Sinsi. So we have few questions. So let's take the questions. The first question is by Manoj Kumar Singh. Do we have any database for Himalayan river fishes?
Yes, we have. We have lot of database for the freshwater fishes. Fish based.
So he has another question. Are you using any sonar based bathymetric flock detection or device for quantitative density estimation of schools for any streams? Is there any device?
Bathymetric?
My
work is mainly for lakes, actually.
Okay. So there's a question by Karthik Naik. He says, I hear from local doctors in Karwar saying that due to Kaiga water discharge to Kali River, eating freshwater fish, shellfish, will create problem to humankind. Does it create problem to humankind?
That is the reason for the fish doesn't come to the market. The Kali fish, the studies have shown that there are radiation. So that's where people either use the water from the Kali downstream or the fish.
Okay. So there's another question by Karthik. Again, what exactly would be the better solution than restricting consumption?
Well, we should not over harvest. We didn't say that don't consume. You should eat fish so that you will be healthy and ready. Youngsters like Karthik Naish should eat lot of fish, but only thing is they should not do the over harvesting. What they harvest, below the sustainable this one, they can consume. There's no restriction on consumption. Okay.
Okay. There's another question by Karthik Naik. He says, even fishermen who dive in those areas have experienced hard water deep down and gradually stopped catching the shellfish, etc. around the place. Is there any solution? Or well, is there any study?
Yeah, this is what the Mangalore University is doing the study. We are still waiting for the results. Okay.
Okay. There's another question by Anusuya Malik. What is the novel technology for fish preservation?
That is only that formalin is the mainly we are using.
So are you talking another about question. For education purposes? So then it is formalin or ethanol is also.
Another question by Anusuya Malik. Is it safe to consume fish in pandemic situation?
Well, the study has not shown any linkage of coronavirus with the fish. Certainly, having fish gives you protein and keeps you immune to the diseases like corona.
Are there any more questions?
Okay, there are no questions.
Yeah.
So, nice to see Karthik being active.
So I see that there are no more questions. So thank you, Sinsi. And I would like to thank all our participants to actively participating in this webinar and asking very good questions. And also Sinsi for making us familiarized with all the different types of freshwater fishes, the statistics about different kinds of fishes available in India and also globally, and their identification, how to morphologically identify them and everything. And thank you everyone for taking part in this webinar.
Fish every day keeps you away from arthritis, respiratory and corona.
Hey fish, every day keep you away from arthritis, respiratory disease, corona, etc.